Getting there. Getting there. More cooked, unless I hear wrong, which is very possible. Yes, for me, I don't like overcooked steak or seafood. I agree. But, there's a timing for everything, right? Timing, heat level, process to make everything taste good. I'm so happy that my dough came out, guys. After the third try of trying to get it to make bubbles, and it finally made bubbles. The key, I think, was definitely adding the sugar, which now I know that. Just fun. This is what I love about stream and things that, viewers want me to do that I've never done before. I love learning new things like this. So I'm so happy that Chris redeemed this. We will be making another new recipe soon, because of another redemption. And that was Rock Pete's was in here in the last week or so and redeemed birria tacos, which I've never made, but as you guys all know, I love making tacos. It's one of my favorite things. So I'm so excited. And I almost made birria recently too. And it didn't work out that day because I was t had too much stuff going on. So I kind of have some of the ingredients already. I'm really excited about it. I have to say, this stream was one of the cheapest in terms of ingredients. Not, I had to get the pizza peel and the stone thing. So, those are things I didn't have. But in terms of ingredients, the ingredients are fairly cheap to make pizza. Want that. We got it made. Let me take you on an escapade. I'm trying to make sure it's not too thin. I want it to be thin, but not too thin. Like this is good. I like this size. It's very thin. You can definitely make your pizza thicker than this, but I just like it this way. Just trying to adjust it so it's a little bit more circular. We got it made. Coming along, coming along. I'm a little bit of a perfectionist if you haven't gotten that yet. Even though pizza is never perfect, I don't think. It can be really tasty and good. Perfect is tough. Plus, pizza's very much like in the eye of the beholder. People like different kinds, that's for sure. Think this is good. I like this. Not an exact perfect circle, but I'm good with it. I'm just go like this around. give it a little bit of an edge and transfer it to this. But I need the parchment paper. Sugar speeds eating, therefore more CO2. Yes. I'm going to hit the bed now. Have fun. Thank you so much for coming by. I really appreciate it. Hope you have a good sleep. Good night. Thank you. Okay. Let me put this on here. The parchment paper, like we did the first time, because that worked out really well. And now we're going to put the EVOO on top. Where's the other EVO? There it is. This one's easier to drizzle. There we go. And I'm gonna spread that out. Where's my, there it is. Spread out the oil. And like we did last time, we're gonna pop this in the oven for a minute or two so that the crust starts to cook first. I'm gonna do that right away. Perfect. Checking the time. Bologna is just hot dog pancakes. I've never thought about that. It's very interesting. I've always had a hard time with a pin on pizza dough. Learned to open by hand. Oh! So good fried. Oh, I do know people love fried. This is so good. So after we make this pizza, we'll make the espresso martini. Who in chat likes espresso martinis? We're done with this. No more rolling pin. Thanks for everyone for hanging out today. I really appreciate it. I'm sorry we've had to do so many restarts, and I really appreciate anybody who's kind of hung out with me, stuck around. So I'm going to try a couple different things on this one. We didn't do on the last one. One is we're going to use some fresh tomatoes on top of the Okay, that's been in there about a minute. Let's take it out. Cool summer. Wait. I want to put it on this. Oof, that's hot. Okay. Oof. There we go. Smells delicious. We're going to start by putting the sauce on. Like I said before, spread it out. I don't want to put too much on. And you want to make sure it's really even all the way around. And we don't put any on the edges. Just leave about an inch on the outside. Less is more with sauce. That looks good. Nice thin layer of the sauce. All right, next. I'm gonna put on some of the mozzarella cheese. There we go. Next, we're gonna put on some of the fresh tomatoes that we just did. Had one last night, not bad. The Weagles in Charlestown used to make the best espresso martini ever. Then they closed. So, you know where I've heard makes really good espresso martinis and they make excellent cocktails because I've been there for cocktails is Brico in the North End. Have you been there, Brownie? I do like Greek Turkish coffee. Only time for sugar and coffee. Interesting. I actually had this Greek liquor at the liquor store. They were doing a pre-tasting. Okay, we're gonna put on some sausage now. Pizza's gonna have more toppings than the last. Starting to debate whether or not it should run on tomatoes. We'll do the sauce. I might take off the tomatoes because we got mushrooms too. We got too much stuff going on this one. I'm just eating the tomatoes. Too much stuff. A couple more pieces of sausage. Now we're gonna do the mushrooms. Trying to fit a reasonable amount of stuff on here without being unreasonable, if that makes sense. And that's about it where we're gonna hit our max here. Yeah, I said Brico brownie. Have you been to Brico for cocktails? They're really good. It wasn't Ouzo. It was called... Damn it. What's it called? It's a Greek liquor that was clear. It was interesting. It was like mint flavored, kind of like a schnapps. I'm making mushroom mozzarella sausage pizza. No, Ken, not quite. You just get to choose what I make and I'll make it. Hi, Bajorn. I love that. How are you? Welcome in. I've been to the Salu Maria Bomb Sammy's. Ooh, I've not been. Not for cocktails at the restaurant, though. That owner has a few places. Ah, okay. You should try cocktails at Brico. It's okay, Mogan. How are you doing? It's good to see you. All right, we're putting this back in. The pizza. Here we go. Boom. That's going to be in there for about 5 minutes. this was our first pizza, which was the margarita pizza. And now we are making a second pizza. And the only reason why I'm not devouring the rest of that pizza is because I want to try this next one. Honestly. And I've been snacking on sausage this whole time. Welcome to the Black Party. Thank you for the follow, Bjorn. And how did you find me? Welcome in. A lot of times peppermint schnapps used in place of ouzo. Oh. I'm trying to remember the name of what it was now, and it's escaping me. I've been quite the stranger lately. Sorry, gonna try my best to fix that. No worries, Moken. I appreciate when you're here and understand sometimes you can't be here. I forgot to put Pecorino Romano on this one. I was gonna do that and I forgot. Sorry, guys. Next time. We had a lot going on. If it's food, I find it. I love that. Where are you from, Bjorn? I'm from Boston. Similar, but not the same. Ouzo hit harder. Ah, okay. Norway. Oh, I love Norway. That's awesome. We have a lot of Norwegians who come in here. I love it. Bakery. It was so bomb. You want to see the first one? Second one's in the oven. And now I just forgot what time we put it in. Damn it. It hasn't been more than 3 minutes, I don't think. What time is it? Let me check it. Okay. I'm gonna wait a minute and then I'm gonna put it on broil. Yes, please. Yes, it's really good. I already had one slice of that one. That looks very nice. Thank you, Bjorn. Blob tugging on bakery. Blob, do you want some pizza? Take some pizza. Aw, thank you, bakery. All right, we're gonna try to get this out. Oh no, we're gonna put it on broil real quick. I'm gonna do the broil for a minute. And then we'll get it out. Oh my god. Thank you for taking care of Blob Bakery. I really appreciate that. Putting some stuff away. Just another 30 seconds or so. I feel like that needs another, like, little bit. It's getting there. Thank you, bakery. We love the 80s in here. I appreciate that. 80s, baby, for the win. So what do you do in Norway, Bjorn? Bjorn? All right. Gotta be done. Yeah.
Oof. That
like sexy. Oh, check it out, guys. It's steamy. This is our sausage mushroom. Mozzarella. And we're putting basil on this one too, because why the heck not? Nomsicles. It looks and smells so good, guys. Look at that. Ugh. Thank you, Brownie. Blob is one of my favorites too. Completely agree. I want to go to Norway. I have a Norwegian living in my building. Oh, that's so cool. I want to go to Norway too. Bakery is one of Blob's favorites. Let's go, Bakery. We love that. Here I go again. Anywhere the coyotes have been reintroduced, they're getting to be a big problem. Reason for being wiped out in the first place. All right, so we're going to take pictures for the Insta. You want to see pictures of my prior stuff? Command-IG. Other streams. This is our first time ever homemade dough pizza making on stream. Let's go. All right. Road trip to Whiskey's for pizza. Let's go, Bakery. Let's go. All right. What do I do with the slicer? Oh my God. I'm excited about this. I'm excited. Oof. Damn it. We're doing the same thing we did before. Just four big slices of pizza. Because I think this one's a little bit better. This one's a little less crunchy on the crust, and I think it's a little bit better than the last one. You guys ready for it? The taste test. Two of all taste tests. Who's ready for it? Who's ready for it? Three in chat if you're ready for me to eat some pizza. Blob comes too. Definitely gotta take Blob. Yeah, the knife is right there. Well, you don't have to have the sausage one, Holly. You can have the other one. What, Blob? Blob, you're supposed to get on a road trip with a Bakery and Holly to come get some pizza. Although Blob just teleports here, to be honest. You order from Domino's, I think? Jose, don't you dare. All right, here we go. Pizza time. Oh my God. It's so freaking good. It's perfectly thin, crispy, delicious. Yes, Grub. I'm gonna order from Domino's too. El Jose, you should have come here to Boston, where all the cool kids hang out and eat pizza homemade. And how are you, Jose? It's good to see you. I'd rather have mushroom pizza due to my thing with dairy. I have to take a special pill. Yes. Fresh mozzarella and basil is the best. Agreed, Bakery. Ew,
Jose, New York is not as good as fresh homemade Boston pizza. Nah, I'm too cold. Right, Bajoran? Look, Dollar's Place is alright. I'm not gonna lie. But this is better. You're just lazy, Jose. Oh, I love that blob. Mm-hmm. Who's ready for an espresso martini? Green chai. That was not pretty good. Sorry, Jose. You cannot compare Domino's to homemade pizza with homemade dough. It ain't the same. Yes, structure. Agreed. This is nice and crispy. Super tasty. Nom 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 nom. Alright, Scrub wants to see an espresso martini. First ever espresso martini made on stream, in addition to the first ever pizzas made on stream. What? Here we go. I'm, like, super happy right now. The thing? Yeah. Alright, we're gonna move this out of the way. I gotta turn off the oven, because we finished our pizzas. Next, made a bit of a mess, not gonna lie, but we do that a lot. I'm gonna make a little bit of a clean effort. A little bit, not a big one. Okay. I'm so happy. It's so tasty. Pizza night, pizza party. Thank you, Scrub. I appreciate you for listening. Refresh dough is best. Sweet potato crust is good. Oh, interesting. Blob. Next time I follow the recipe correctly, it was pretty good though. Nice. Fresh dough. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna make a drink. We're gonna do it, guys. I'm super hot. It's super hot in this kitchen right now. Am I hungry enough to get more food from the fridge? I think the answer is yes. If you're asking, then yes. You're asking, the answer is yes. All right. Thank you, bakery. What do we need? We're making a bit of orange vanilla espresso martini. The espresso, which we have. Here's the espresso.
I am right, Day. I'm pretty much always right. Coffee liqueur, which is our new coffee liqueur we got today. Called Tia Maria. Let's see what it smells like. I really love the smell of that. That's really good. All right. Amaro Nonino signature syrup. Got it. I'm gonna put some of this other stuff over there. Amaro Nonino is yet another Italian ingredient that we're using today. Having a glass of wine? What kind of wine, Holly? You don't do cold coffee at all. Ooh, how many people in chat don't like cold coffee? Very interesting. Shots and chase with coffee? Let's go. Let's go. All right, so we need the shaker. We're actually going to shake something today. We haven't even done this yet. We've been making simple cocktails that haven't required the shaker. So shaker, we need a strainer. And we'll need some ice in a minute. I'm going to pull up the recipe for this. First I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But there's been so many nights. Okay, we're gonna grab some ice. I don't know how to get along until you're back. Ain't back to bother me. Go on now, go. What's up, the door? Alright, we got the ice in. We're gonna need our glass. We don't have martini glasses, but we do have similar size glasses. They're grandma's glasses, and that's what we're going to use. All right, let's go. I don't drink coffee at all. I also don't drink at home. Coffee, because it doesn't work on my and alcohol, because I just never have the urge to when at home. Yeah, I get it. Moscato. Okay, nice. I drink coffee hot 24/7, 365. I can't drink caffeine after a certain time, or else it will keep me up. So we are using decaf espresso, because I would not sleep otherwise. Holly, you are drinking at home, aren't you? You're drinking Moscato. I'm very confused. Very confused by that one. All right. Let's see, we're going to start with 1 ounce of the espresso. Where is my little thingamajiggy? Another useless thing in this world, decaf. Yeah, I actually like the flavor of coffee and espresso. So for me, decaf is not useless. If it was caffeinated right now, I probably would not sleep at all tonight, because I can't drink caffeine after like 5 o'clock. You don't drink coffee. Okay. All right, next. What do we got now? 1 ounce of the coffee liqueur. So I prefer hot coffee, but I will have iced coffee when it is super hot out, but it also has to be, that could have been extremely dangerous. Did I put away my olive oil without the cap? Yes. If that fell, that would have been disastrous. I can drink a pot of coffee just before bed and sleep like a baby. My brother's like that, Scrub. I am not. Very sensitive. And I normally actually drink tea most days. I drink coffee only when I can really go out for it. I don't like making it at home much. But I do like really strong coffee. And also, we are behind on our trivia. Three in chat if you want some trivia questions. All right. Next, what do we have next? I lost mine. Does your brother have? No, he doesn't have ADHD. Not that I know of, anyway. 1 ounce of the Amaro Nonino. Which is, like I said, another product of Italy. That's what makes this Italiano. And 1/2 ounce of my signature simple syrup, which is a salted vanilla simple syrup. And think it'll work really well in this. That's the right one. I don't label them because I like to smell them and figure out which one it is. I can also tell usually by the color which simple syrup it is in my fridge. Right, there we go. That's done. I think that's it. I think we're just gonna, we need an orange twist, but we're just gonna shake and strain. Shake time, guys. I hate this part. There we go. Gonna strain this in this glass. Next, we're going to add an orange twist. Again, we made this earlier, but they're easy. Just glide your peeler aggressively around. Boom. Press it over the drink. Stick that in there. Perfect. We're gonna take a picture. Picture time. All right, looks delicioso. Here we are, chat. Our first ever espresso martini, which I've never even drank, so I don't even know if this is gonna taste good or not. But cheers to chat. Thank you for hanging out. And it's time for some trivia. I like it. This is really well balanced. So it's not a traditional espresso martini because I didn't make it with vodka. I made it with Amaro Nonino instead, and I feel like this is more my vibe. Just gonna say. I feel like I'm not a vodka person. This is more my vibe. Yeah, that is like good. And I really like the coffee liqueur. the vanilla, the salt, the orange, those notes all hit. And I love that combination. Yes, Holly, we're getting to the trivia. Hold your horses. Okay. What is America's least favorite pizza topping? Least favorite pizza topping. Unlimited guesses. Just go. And to be honest, I've not even sat this entire stream, which is probably why my feet hurt. So just give me a moment, please. We're gonna sit. Olives, durian, pineapple. No, the least favorite pizza topping, like what you put on the pizza, the least favorite to put on top of it, not the least amount of toppings. Okay, cool bakery. It don't go on pizza. It's not pineapple, and it's not olives or durian. Durian is a weird fruit thing. And bakery, you got it with the anchovies. Let's go. You're in the U.S., right, bakery? A gross-smelling fruit? Yes. Like, famously gross-smelling. Yes, exactly. Famously gross-smelling. Let's go, bakery. You're in. You get an entry. Got you. There we go. In the next baking giveaway entry, let's get to the next question. What condiment is popular for Japanese people to put on pizza? Condiment, guys. Unlimited guesses, go! By the way, how's school doing? I'm assuming you're almost finished for the year. So I'm almost finished for the semester, but I get a week off and then I have another semester. It's like three semesters in a year. It's weird. But it's going well. I have one more exam on Monday night and then an exam due Wednesday that I've already basically finished. Brownie! How did you know that? Ew, so gross. How did you know that, Brownie? Did you actually know that, or was that a pure guess? Pew, pew, a brownie. For crab rangoon pizza? Cute pie? Soy sauce. Actually, soy sauce is a great guess, Bob. I would have guessed that. Sweet and sour sauce? I love that guess, too. Ketchup. What, Scrub? Wait, how did we get on condoms? I'm so confused. Don't be gross. Knew it. Have you got the actual brand, though? Oh, is that true? Oh, too bad you're too slow, Mac. No, that was not the question. That's not the question. Rolling your sleeves up, please. Hi, Abo. How are you? Abo? Welcome in. I have no idea. Oh, sorry. Condiments. Oh, scrub. I get the joke now. Okay, one more question. Okay. In what year? Unlimited guesses, guys. What year? Unless you guys want me to do the closest to the actual year. What do you guys want me to do? Closest to the actual year? Or you have to actually guess the year? We'll do the closest. We'll do the closest. Closest to the actual year wins. In what year did the first frozen pizza appear in stores? First ever frozen pizza. Only one guess, closest guess wins. 65? 47? 64? Ooh. 41? Let's go. I'm so excited. And I just can't hide it. You know, this is tasty, but I couldn't imagine drinking more than one of these. Just say. Are we done with the guesses? The closest guess goes to Scrub. 1962! He stole that from you, Brownie. You were so close, Brownie. Good job, Scrub. Shit, yeah. Let's go. You're in. I feel like we missed an hour of trivia. So if I see enough sevens in chat, I'll do three more questions. Because I don't think we did questions at nine. I think I was too busy with the pizza thing. Jax Pascalis, Red Baron, and Urban Farmer are some of the best frozen pizza. Oh, look at that. What does everybody else feel about frozen pizza? What's your favorites? Why sevens? Because pretty much everything I put for chat is either three or seven. Because those are my favorite numbers. Red Baron, decent. Haven't had the others. I'm trying to think of frozen pizza, what I've had. I feel like DiGiorno. I've definitely had DiGiorno frozen pizza, but it's been a long time since I've had frozen pizza. Pascale's, or however you spell it, has really good breakfast pizza. What's on a breakfast pizza? Like, bacon? Are there actual eggs on it? I question its frozenness with eggs. Celeste? Not so great. No, Celeste is not. But ubiquitous. It's true. Very true. Oh, man. Okay, nobody put sevens in chat, so I guess no more trivia. Thank you, Blob. Fixing the music for you guys. Let's go! George's Hot Sauce! Thank you so much for the raid. How was your stream? Welcome in, everybody. Hi, my name's Whiskey Monster. Everybody calls me Whiskey, and I do food and drink streams, and George is some hot sauce. He's an awesome sauce person. I met him in Texas, which is a lot of fun. If you don't already check him out, please, please do so. He's a really cool guy. Hi, Yax. It's good to see you again. You got more rated? Honestly, I think this is my third or fourth rate of the stream. Let's go. Amazing. How's your stream, George? What did you do? Cheese sauce and sausage gravy have been seen on... Oh, interesting. We made pizzas. We had a pizza party. And this is our last cocktail that we made, which is an espresso martini. It's quite good. So yeah, we're just hanging out. Welcome in, everyone. Woo! Hello, George. Hello. Blob exploring bakeries, lot for comfiest spot. There you go, Blob. I'm sure bakery has a super comfy lot. Hi, Southern. How are you? Welcome in. Marbles on stream and food trivia. Oh, I love that. We're playing trivia too. So all month long, we're doing fun, different things, trivia related and whatnot, to get, if you're in the United States, you can qualify to get into my baking giveaway. So I make baked goods on stream and then I give them away. And if you're in the United States, you can qualify. If you're not in the United States, you can still guess the trivia questions right and then give it to someone, your entry to someone in the chat. So we were just restarting the music. Let's see if that worked. Guys, did that work out? Hi, Coors Light. How are you? Welcome in. What, why might they have this gluten-free pizza? Freshetta. Interesting. What did you make recently, bakery? I'm hardly ever get reads, but we still had a good stream today. Well, it's up and down for me, honestly. Some days I get lots of raids, sometimes not at all, but I appreciate each and every raid, and that you chose to bring your community in here is super nice of you, George. Thank you. Fluffy hair must have comfy lap. You have freshetta there, bakery? Me too. But if anybody just came in chat, what's your favorite pizza? Today we made a margarita pizza. I can show you. This was the margarita pizza. Homemade fresh pizza dough, mozzarella cheese, homemade tomato sauce, and basil. And then we also made a hot and sweet sausage with mushrooms, mozzarella, and basil, and tomato sauce. So, they were both awesome. It was my first time ever making pizza on stream. My first time making my own pizza dough. And it was a lot of fun. Not enough, yes. Buckeye pea cornbread casserole. Oh, yes. You posted that on the Discord and it looked really interesting. So, now that you guys know the trivia ways to, I guess, get into the baking giveaway, we're going to do three more questions. Yes, you did, bakery. I appreciate that. So, three more questions. Since we've talked about this many, many of times tonight, get your fingers ready. First person to guess it wins. You can guess as many times as you want. A classic Hawaiian pizza has tomato sauce, cheese, ham, and pineapple. Where was this style of pizza invented? Where was the Hawaiian pizza invented? Come on, people. Brownie. Wow, a lot of people knew this. I did not know that it was created in Canada. Brownie got it for the first one to guess Canada. Good job, Brownie. Not at my house. Best answer, Scrap. Hawaii is a good guess. I would have guessed Hawaii. Hawaii, I wouldn't have guessed Hawaii. Oh, god damn it. I know you were like a second too late. Or a minute, really, technically. California pizza traders. Oh, come on, eh? All right, next question. In what city in America is there a pizza museum? Pizza museum. What city in America? Not New York. As many guesses as you want. I love that scum. Am I snacking on sausage still? Yes. Nice guess, Mac, but no. No New York, no Chicago. US cities, you can guess whatever you want. Nope, scum. Whatever you guys want. I said US cities, Brownie. Can you follow the directions, eh? San Diego. Oh, Wales. No. In what US city is the is there a pizza museum? So, what's US city? Let's go, Scrub. Scrub got it with Philly. YMCA. I think that was only two questions, right? I need one more. What is the most popular pizza topping in India? Oh What's popular to put on pizza in India? You, George. That's really nice. I love your TikTok and Instagram content. It's a lot of fun. Beef. Pepperoni. Shit, not a clue. Seriously, really whiskey? Onion. Cheese. Cheese is not a topping. Cheese is a requirement. Peppers. No. Nope. Chicken. Nope. This is gonna be interesting. No, and no. Masala. I like that guess. It's not right, but I like it. It's an option. Think extra. So it's a topping. I guess so, Scrub, technically. But to me, cheese has to be on a pizza no matter what. So. And it's not, it's just not right. Snails. Interesting. No. Goat. No, but it's a good guess. Goat cheese. That's an interesting one, George. Anchovy? Nope. Feta? No. Now, I will give you this. I don't know that this is a topping. This is my hint. I don't know that this is considered a topping on in US places. Like, I would not think to put this on pizza. I have had feta on pizza. Yes, I'm not too shocked by that. It's a type of cheese. I could see people putting feta on cheese on pizza. This is something that I would not have thought of to put on pizza. Although, it's not so obscure as to be frog legs. Mushrooms. No. No, mushrooms is a common topping. Think uncommon thing you could put on pizza. Pecans. I like that guess. It's quite interesting. Mango. No. I like both feta and frog legs. Oh gosh. I may have stumped you guys.
Chutney?
No. Strawberries?
No.